Hello students, welcome back to GK's Education. I hope your study is going well and you are doing your topics day by day with all your concepts clear in your mind. So, today we are going to do a disposal of amount due to retiring partner. Up to this level, we have done that what are the treatments of goodwill, revaluation account, the capital account, and all the things regarding the death or retirement of a partner. Now, the final amount, what a retiring partner should be paid and how the payment is done, this is what we are going to do in this topic, in this today's video. Yes, this the outgoing partner's capital account is settled as per the terms of the partnership deed. Means the outgoing partner's account, the payment is made to him as per the conditions or the terms pre-decided in the partnership deed. That is the lump sum immediately. There are some conditions or some ways where we can make him a payment. It may be in lump sum immediately. The total amount can be paid in cash or by bank payment. Number two, in various installments. Maybe if the firm is not having the sufficient funds, so it can create a loan account and pay the installments with or without interest as agreed. It can pay the interest as per the agreement, or if it is not agreed in to pay the interest, so without interest it can also make the payments. And number three, partly in cash immediately and partly in installments at the agreed intervals. It may have some funds but not the sufficient funds, so in that case it can be decided that the firm can pay part of the amount due in cash and the remaining part can be paid by installments as per the agreed intervals. And now, in the absence of any agreement, it is a point which has to be noted or which has to be kept in mind while doing the questions. In the absence of any agreement, Section 37 of Indian Partnership Act 32 is applicable, which explains that the outgoing partner has an option to receive either the interest at the rate of 6% till the date of the payment or such share of profit which has been earned with his money. That means it is given that he can be given or he can receive, he can charge interest of 6% per annum till the date of the payment, or he can take such share of profit which is earned by his money, his share of money which is not paid to him, that is based on the capital ratio. So these things have to be kept in mind while giving the payment to the outgoing, retiring or the deceased partner. So the total amount due to the retiring partner is calculated after making all the adjustments and should be paid immediately. That means we have to calculate the capital amount due to the partner after making all the adjustments. What all the adjustments? They may be regarding revaluation account, maybe regarding the reserves. Everything should be done. After that, the total amount due to him is, or a share of profits should also be transferred to him. Only then after that the amount due to him is calculated. And now, if the firm is not in a position to make the payment immediately, the amount due is transferred to the retiring partner's loan account. It means if the firm does not have the sufficient money or funds to pay, so the firm will create a partner's loan account, and as and when the amount is paid, it is it is debited to his account. And when we make the payment as per the agreement, it is debited to his loan account. Now the entries are, at this point the entries we make are: when the retiring partner is paid cash full, when he is paid the payment in cash, full payment, then retiring partner's capital account debit to cash or bank account. And when the retiring partner's whole amount is treated as loan, then retiring partner's capital account debit to retiring partner's loan. We create the capital account is credit balance, so we debit it and we create a new loan account, that is at the name of that retiring or outgoing partner. And when the retiring partner is partly paid in cash and the remaining amount is treated as loan, in that case retiring partner's capital account is debited to cash and to retiring partner's loan account with the amount which is created as loan to cash with the amount which has been paid to him immediately. So this is how this disposal of amount will be done, or finally the payment is made. Now let us do some examples to make our points clear. Again, there is some other part. When the few entries are more, when the loan account is settled by paying any installment includes the principal and interest. And now when the loan account has been created and when the loan is paid, in that case interest account debit for the interest amount of the loan, interest account debit to retiring partner's loan account. And then for the payment of installment, retiring partner's loan account debit to cash and bank account. So now the points which we have to kept in mind is, which we have to keep, the balance of retiring partner's loan account is shown on the liability side. The balance is always on the liability side of the balance sheet till the loan is paid off completely. Now let us do this example. The balance sheet of A, B and C, who are sharing the profits in the ratio 4:3:3, is here. There is land and building, plant and machinery, electronic typewriters, stocks, sundry debtors, provision, bank balance, creditors, bills payable, reserves and their capital accounts also. And now on April 1, B retires. And on the following term, goodwill is valued at 14,000, stock, land and building is to be appreciated by 10%, plant machinery and electronic typewriters are to be depreciated by 10%, sundry debtors considered to be good. There is a liability of 2,000 for the payment of outstanding salary to the employees. This liability has not been shown in the balance sheet, but the same is to be recorded now. And now the important point, amount payable to B is to be transferred to his loan account. Now prepare the revaluation, partner's capital, PAL and balance sheet after the retirement. Now let us check it out. First, there is a revaluation account is available here. First point was goodwill is not entered. The first point was stock in land and building is to be appreciated by 10%. So here by stock, by stock 20,000, 10% of it 2,000, and by land and building 36,000, the 10% is 3,600. The another was plant and machinery and electronic typewriters are to be depreciated by 10%. Now plant and machinery is 28,000, 10% here. Electronic typewriter is 8,000, 10% is here. And then another point was sundry debtors are considered to be good. That means no provision is required. So provision for debts, that is here. It will be written back, so no provision will be there. And then after that, the another point was outstanding salary. Now it has to be recorded in the book, so it is an expense. Here is outstanding salary 2000 and the balance is 2000. It is a profit figure which is divided among the all the partners in the profit sharing ratio, that is 4:3:3. So it is here. And now come to the partners' capital accounts. The opening balances are 32,000, 24 and 20. These are the opening balances. There was a reserve given. Here it is. The reserve was given 20,000 and it is here. It is again divided in 4:3:3. And then revaluation accounts profit, which we did here, it will be transferred here. Now this is done. Up to this level, the question is clear. And now the basic adjustment part. We will take the value of goodwill. Look at the adjustment of goodwill. Now old sharing ratio is 4:3:3, and so the gain ratio is when the you can say one partner goes out and new profit sharing is not given. So it is assumed that the old profit sharing ratio will exist and it will be their gain ratio. So their gain ratio is 4:3. Now goodwill is 14,000. So well, B's share, the outgoing partner's share of goodwill is 14,000 into 3/10. This one share, 4,200. B's share is distributed between A and C in the gain ratio. How? So A's share of goodwill is 4,200. B's part of goodwill is 4/7, that is 2,400. And C's share is 3/7, that is 1,800. And now the entry will be A's capital account debit 2,400, C's capital account debit 1,800 to B's capital account 4,200. So the amount will be distributed among the remaining partners in their gain ratio, and this entry will be in B's capital, it will be by A and by C 1,800 and 2,400. This entry is here, and in A's capital it is to B's capital, and C's capital count it is again to B's capital by 24 and 1,800. So this entry is here, this part of entry. And now we will balance the accounts. First, A's account will be balanced, all these plus and subtracted, the balance comes out to be this much amount. And now B's account is add all these things and then nothing to subtract. So B's balance is transferred to loan account. It is not balance carried down. It is a loan account is created here. And then C's just balance, add up all these and subtract this, and balancing amount comes out to be this. Now balance sheet, the balance sheet part, land and building. It was, let us check it out, land and building. It was 36,000. Now 36,000 plus appreciation, this plant and machinery 28,000 minus depreciation, this electronic typewriter 8,000 minus depreciation, stock as it is, stock is appreciation, so 22,000, sundry debtors no provision, that means total amount, and bank same amount as no changes there, no payment. And in case of the creditors, now let us check creditors, 7,000, same figure, bills payable also same figure, no change, reserves are transferred, and B's loan account will appear here. Then capital accounts of A and C, their balances, and the outstanding salary entry will be here. So this will be the balance sheet. This is how this total question will be done. I hope you are getting your points very much clear regarding these questions. So please go on doing the sums and getting your points clear. Do not forget to like and subscribe my channel. Thank you and have a nice time.